of influencers.
I want to talk about copyright. After the creation, who owns the rights?
There's a division in who owns the rights, because it's kind of a broad question, right? There's a difference between owning rights on social channels, on social media and online, and there's a difference between online and offline rights. So sometimes we have clients that say, okay, I want to purchase additional offline rights for injecting some content on posters and showcase them in my store. That's something that lives outside of the agreement that we make with our influencers today. A lot of influencers are also getting more savvy, and they're starting to realize that when clients want to repurpose or reuse content, they should be paying extra for it, because they're essentially licensing content that someone else has created, and they're repurposing it on other online assets, which is something you effectively have to pay for. So we look at it from at a case-by-case basis, which means that some clients want to purchase additional rights, which can be 3, 6, 9, or 12 months. And some clients even want to extend that and say, well, we also want the rights over, printed versions, or we also want to be able to use content in print or in magazine for ads. So those are kinds of the general nuances between the different types of rights there are. But it's a very complex domain.
Who's making all these contracts?
My partner, Dan. He was a lawyer at DLA Piper for 8 to 10 years.
But is he a lawyer for Dutch law?
Yeah.
So it's all by Dutch law?
Yes.
With any brand you work with?
Yeah.
Follow The Moti on Instagram, Facebook, and Snapchat.